You know, I would have liked to have been at the hearing. My sister would have liked to have been there so we could, you know, talk on our own behalf. You know, I mean, this is about us.
Gerald Amirault watched Tuesday's hearing from home with his wife, Patty. He and his sister, Cheryl, both convicted of sexually abusing numerous children at the Fells Acres daycare in Malden in the 1980s, were asked not to come to this week's hearing because it was not meant to be a retrial. Amirault believes it became that anyway.
The hearing was so disjointed and out of control that it was just an embarrassment.
Victims and their families were allowed to speak at the hearing.
With all the things he has done to me, I live with the life sentence as a result.
Jennifer Bennett was 4 at the time. The Amirault's lawyer says the children were persuaded to say that they were abused.
We've always been respectful of the other side. We've never, you know, we look at them like they've been victimized by the system, just like we were.
The prosecutor at the time maintains the case was solid and argued against the pardons.
It would be just plain wrong to approve them.
But Governor Baker said he doubts the evidence based on how police investigated at the time. Baker only withdrew the pardon bids when he realized he did not have the votes.
We were grateful that we were able to go forward with it. I wished it had been successful. I mean, I'd done all my time. I spent 18 years in prison. I've been on parole for 19 years. I've had an ankle bracelet on for almost 18 years, but my life will go on.
In 10 months, Amirault's bracelet will come off, but he will still be required to register as a sex offender once a year. At the State House, I'm Mary Saladna, WCVB News Center 5.